You may have walked past the one-of-a-kind art installation at Civic Park in downtown Phoenix and asked, "What is that?" Well, it's called Her Secret is Patience. And as you'll see, this artistic sculpture is a feat of both art and science.
One of the amazing things about art is that whenever artists come up with ideas, essentially they're creating a problem for themselves to solve. How do we hold up something that is 30,000 pounds or more and do it safely for decades? When I first saw this sculpture on paper, I thought this had enormous potential to actually invigorate this area in a way that none of us could imagine until it was up. This is a world, which is an extraordinary world we're in, where you can start with an idea on paper. It turns into a digital file or a computer file, and then somebody else has to actually turn that digital file back into something that's tangible. One of the things that I think about when I look at this sculpture is this reality, is that we still build our cities by hand. Back in 2006, City Council approved funding to do a major artwork on this location of downtown Phoenix. At the time, nobody knew what that artwork could be, but the idea was that it should be something significant and a real centerpiece. It's an extraordinary bit of invention. The artist comes up with this marvelous idea, and pretty soon you have engineers involved trying to figure out how to make that idea live in the world. From 2006 on through 2007 and 2008, the Office of Arts and Culture, which is a city agency, and the public art program that's part of that agency, issued a call for artists. And we received about 178 applicants from around this region, the nation, and the world. That group was then paired to six finalists, and Janet Echelman was the winning commission. That sculpture is called Her Secret is Patience, and it was installed in 2009. The artist actually drew that quote from Ralph Waldo Emerson, and it was a quote about the pace of nature. And of course, the pace of nature is that her secret is patience. This is a very small park. It's just about 2.7 acres, bracketed by light rail on both sides and development on both sides. She had this sort of inspired idea to bring the sculpture up above the ground plane so that it didn't occupy a lot of that precious 2.7 acres, but it could be up in the air. And that really was the winning idea. We think of artists working alone in their studios and then showing their works in galleries and museums or outdoors. But when you look at this sculpture, what you're seeing is an extraordinary combination of talents, from engineering to fabrication to installation. It's painted steel, the rings, the poles, stainless steel cables, but then you also have the netting itself. There are thousands of knots that were needed to develop this net, thousands of feet of twine. All of this had to be tied and knotted. With all of this twine and all of this cording, I think it's safe to say that this is always going to have some pretty strong ties to downtown Phoenix. When I look at this work, it just makes me realize how many people need to be involved to do great things in our society. It's not just one person, it's not just one office or one community, but it's I think a great expression of the power of democracy to come together and develop some really beautiful things that people can then enjoy for decades to come.